and converting these into revenue. In Africa, across this diverse continent, there's obviously a great deal more informality. There's a lot of intermediaries really important in building community, in providing pathways for expression, and supporting cultural and creative expression, which can pivot into a creative economy. The intermediaries come in many shapes and sizes, and often are individual entrepreneurs themselves, to recognise that by building a community, nurturing an ecosystem, you can in turn build an economy in which you can yourself thrive. There aren't as many formal development agency models, and there are less structured strategic approaches from the likes of universities, municipalities, and government. So that is changing, and there are agencies like EVOS in Kenya, which is a really strong intermediary development organisation, which is also investing in and funding the creative industry. So again, the diversity of opportunity needs to be emphasised. In that intermediary landscape, I think one of the important things to recognise is the role of hubs play. Hubs are physical but also digital centres for collaboration and production. So if you're, from a career perspective, looking to plug in and engage with the creative industry across different parts of Africa, then identify where the hubs are. Where are the people meeting, engaging socially, and collaboratively in terms of value chains around creative production, and also in terms of how that changes, how they're turning production into market development. And there's a plethora of growing ecosystem of hubs in every city pretty much in across the continent, whether they be cultural centres, whether they be universities, but also things like festivals are really important catalysts and amplifiers for the creative industries across the continent. And those are the places to plug in, to connect and build cultural relations. I think we can learn a lot about resilience. That youthfulness, that zeal, that energy, and doing so in a context where policy is still emergent, where there's a lack of resources, a lack of investment in many contexts. So we can learn from the business models that have been developed in that environment, particularly in a post-COVID context, as the economies are struggling and will need to change and recover in different parts of the world, including Korea and the UK. Finally, one on digital. in my previous work, they took a huge opportunity for a career supporting the technological infrastructure in Africa. I also think, though, that there's huge opportunities in terms of focusing on storytelling and content and aesthetics. And if you could go for a collaboration, for example, between some of your emerging talents, whether it's in fashion or music or design, with some of the incredible talents in different parts of Africa, I think that would be deeply powerful, but it also could drive innovation and generate new content, which would be really distinctive and exciting for global audiences. So don't be focused on the artwork, it's on the content and the stories as well.